Morning, legends! It is Wednesday morning, the 29th of November, the day after my 30th birthday. I haven't vlogged the last couple of days. I had my 30th birthday party on Sunday. So Monday was a slow, relaxing day. And yesterday was my actual birthday, so spent the morning working, got a lot done, and then had the afternoon with my mum and my twin brother, whose birthday it was as well, so I had a really nice afternoon. Then we went out for dinner with our partners last night, so a really great celebration. I've got a 16-year-old young cricketer who's doing work experience with me this week. He'll be here shortly. His name's Danny, so we'll chat with him shortly. He's helping me this week, so really happy to have him doing various jobs for me and teaching him a bit about cricket mentoring, what goes on. Got a busy day of coaching this afternoon, 7 lessons, so looking forward to getting stuck in with them. Had a busy morning this morning, just updating the financials. It's just part of being a small business is making sure everything's up to date, all the admin, so I spent a couple of hours going through all of that. So looking forward to vlogging again today and the next few days and giving you guys an insight into what I'm up to. Turning 30 yesterday obviously means that I'm no longer in my 20s. That's a decade done. It's quite a big milestone, big birthday, but I spent a few moments yesterday reflecting on my 20s and I am really happy with where I'm at. Obviously, there's some things that could be changed. I could have done differently, but I'm really pleased with my 10 years as a 20-something, and I'm even more excited for what the 30s hold. I'm really excited for where Cricket Mentoring's at and where we're going, and I can't wait to help you guys, more and more people from around the world, improve their cricket and hopefully live out their dreams as I did as a professional cricketer with Middlesex. So really excited for the next 10 years as a 30-something. As I mentioned, we had our celebration for our birthday on the weekend. Becca's turning 30 next week, so we had a joint 30th/Australian wedding party as we got married in the UK a few months ago and a lot of our friends couldn't come, so we were very lucky to have lots of good close friends and family come, and here's a few of our the cards that they've given us and our balloons from the party. Super grateful for all our friends and family for being so generous. They're absolute legends. Gratitude is such a great thing to practice and really make a habit in your life. Sitting here with young Danny Schmedley, who is my work assistant for the week. How you going, big fella?
Yeah, pretty good.
Why do you have to help me this week? What's the crack with school?
I've got work experience for a week, so.
So he's come and joined Cricket Mentoring, which is going well. He's doing a bit of research for me at the moment for our tour to India next year. For those of you that haven't heard, we haven't done much promo about it yet, but we're taking a group of players to India in April next year. So got to put some stuff together around that very soon, and Danny's doing some research for me. So really pleased to have him while I do some more business admin. Cheers, big boy.
Well done. Okay, nice. You could have gone back across more, but you went back onto your back foot nicely. Well done, Aaron. Okay, you moved inside it, but we want to try and score off that. Done. That's a beautiful shot. You got all your weight coming into the ball there. So the difference between that one and the others, you got more power then. The others, you've hit really nice bat swing, but you got your weight going into the ball there, which gives you power. Well done. Good balance. Yeah! Shot, boy. Good. Great footwork. Back and across. Excellent. Okay, not bad. Not bad. At least it's coming straight. Playing it well.
More books delivered, legends. As I've said, if you follow closely my vlog, I get books delivered quite regularly. I don't read them all straight away, but I like to build a library and then I can take bits and pieces. We get a lot of quotes from books for our social media and so forth. So like getting different books. So I've got one here, Man's Search for Meaning by Viktor Frankl, which is highly recommended by a number of people that I follow and admire. So interesting book, that one. We've got another one here, which, as I said before, I don't remember what I've ordered. Ah, this is a good one. The Worry Trick. How your brain tricks you into expecting the worst and what you can do about it. So these sort of books are written by
experts and really knowledgeable people. And by reading this sort of stuff, we can pick out and suck out the knowledge that they've acquired over a number of years. So reading is such a powerful thing. And then we can teach it to the people that we coach and mentor. So a great book that we will certainly start to use in our programs, the things and the lessons from that book. And finally, we got another one, which is The Subtle Art of Not Giving Up, which is meant to be quite good, a counterintuitive approach to living a good life. So again, more lessons from someone who's an expert in their field and understands the mindset of life and the psychology of people. So hopefully we'll get to read that one again soon as well.
Hey vlog, I am just down here at Richardson Park in South Perth. Just been shooting some videos. I've had Danny throwing at me. I've had the GoPro out, shooting some different angles, shooting some videos for Ecos, which we'll be launching very soon. We'll have more information on that soon for you, but that's a training tool that you all should be using in the future. So really excited by that. Absolutely cracking day here in Perth. It's great to have Danny helping me. Got a nice little thrower there, being able to hit balls and sort of do demonstrations for the videos, which has been great. I think it's really important that all youngsters throw lots of balls. I think when I've done coaching in the past and I've asked players to throw to each other, throwing has often been horrendous. When I was younger and I was growing up, we'd always be outside and we'd always be throwing, kicking, catching, doing those sorts of things. But in this day and age, people are inside or they're on their smartphones or on their iPads or something, and they're not as active as they used to be. So I think throwing is a really important skill in cricket, and it's something that's completely underrated and it's not practiced enough. So make sure you're throwing as often as you can. Baseballers throw hundreds of balls every single day, so there's nothing wrong with throwing a lot. You just got to condition your arm, condition your body to do it, and you got to increase your volume as you go. You don't want to just start throwing hundreds and hundreds of balls straight away. But if you want to get better, a great way to get better as a batter is to throw balls with someone else. You don't always need a coach there. You can just throw balls at one another, and that's a great way to train your body for throwing as well. So make sure you're all practicing your throwing. One lesson done. Just had an hour session with a guy who's working on his spin, so doing some bowling with him outdoors. Now getting to Muleman's, got 5 lessons, so late finish tonight, but really looking forward to getting on my feet. I really enjoy being active and helping these guys get better. Hey vlog, it is 10 p.m. and I just wanted to wrap up today. Been a great day, had a busy afternoon of coaching. Something that I wanted to just go through with you guys is something that's quite common when driving the ball. And I haven't really done a video or spoken about this too much before, but it's about when the top wrist collapses and the bottom hand takes over. I see a lot of players driving the ball and their top wrist on contact collapses and then the bottom hand takes over and they end up in this sort of position. And here you can see that the top wrist is really weak and collapsed and there's no real control of the bat. And what that often means is A, the player loses power because they don't have a strong contact, and B, they often spoon it up in the air. The bottom hand's trying to do too much. If the timing's just a little bit off, then they get through the shot too early and their bat angles up and spoons up in the air. So the key to driving well is having a really strong top wrist, and you want to try and keep your top wrist in front of your bottom wrist. You don't want them to get level or that bottom hand to get in front. If we had a line coming from the ceiling, you want that top wrist to be in front of the bottom hand. And then when you follow through, you almost just keep them level, and you want to raise that top wrist. You don't want to sort of get too far out in front with that bottom hand taking over. Even if you sort of follow through with your bat high, you raise your hands up above your head. You sort of raise that wrist, raise that elbow. So that's just something to think about. I might do a proper video on that soon, but thought I'd just touch on that tonight. So I haven't vlogged for a few days, back vlogging today. I'll be vlogging the next few days, and then again on Saturday when we're chasing 290. So hope you've enjoyed today's vlog. It's been another busy but great day. And if you haven't done so already, please like and comment below, subscribe to our channel, turn on the bell so that you get notifications when we post something so you don't miss it. And thanks for joining me, thanks for your time, and I'll see you again tomorrow.